Good morning, everyone. Stocks in a strong reversal yesterday, and the dollar and yen are lower. So according to the FX market, the risk trade is still on. Aussie and euro are higher. Commodities are performing well because of dollar weakness. US Treasuries are about to break key support around 117.20, which could be an important intraday trigger for more stock strength. Not that high interest rates in itself is positive for stocks, but it just shows that the market prefers to have risk rather than safety. Today, the S&P 500 trendline resistance is around 1114, which is around, well, a small 2% higher from here. Could go that high today, but we doubt it. But let's see. Earnings show improvement generally, but there's an ongoing discussion about the quality of financial shares earnings. We have a buy and dips stance today in DAX towards 58.19, 52.55 in FTSE 100, and 10.93 in S&P 500. Also, by the break of 10.65 in gold, looks like it also had a strong reversal yesterday after looking weak early in the day. So target 10.76 today in gold. Buy and dips, sorry, yeah, in silver towards 17.50 and target 17.70. But oil still looks overdone, so we would like to sell on rallies towards 82.50. We have some important earnings out today, Honeywell and Microsoft and Schlumberger. Especially the Microsoft earnings, of course, will be important for the markets. And data today, IFO figures at 10 o'clock CET, 10:30 CET, UK GDP figures. And we have industrial new orders in the Eurozone at 11 o'clock CET. Then we have existing home sales in the US at 16 o'clock CET. So that's all important, but I believe that Microsoft earnings will be most important today. If you look at the data, the risk trade is also should be on. Corporate bond spreads are continuing to narrow. We also see Eastern European 10-year rates versus bunds continuing to narrow. The VIX is now on a downtrend even below 25. And the US break-even in 10-year inflation rates are edging higher still, so that should be a positive. So all in all, we are close to key resistance levels, 1114 S&P 500 and 1121. That's the 50% Fibonacci retracement. We haven't really been making up our minds yet if we believe that there's upside above these levels to be had. So we're still neutral in the short term. Well, today we have a buy and dips. We still believe a test is likely, but let's see if we break higher. The S&P 500 is having a major wedge that needs to be broken either on the upside or downside within the next, I'd say, 2 weeks or something like that. Let's see. Have a nice weekend.